All right, that sounds promising. All right, let's get the show on the road then. All right, that sounds promising. All right, let's get the show on the road then. All right, that sounds promising. All right, let's get the show on the road. Oh, okay, I figured out what the problem was. And the freaking, I was lurking my Twitch channel to make sure that it actually was working properly, and I was picking up the audio from there, so I didn't have the stream muted. Okay then. Feel stupid
from
now?
The moment I understood the weakness of my flesh, it disgusted me. I craved the strength and certainty of steel. I aspired to the purity of the blessed machine. Your kind cling to your flesh, as if it will not decay and fail you. One day the crude biomass that you call the temple will wither, and you will beg my kind to save you. But I am already saved. For the machine is immortal. Even in death, I serve the Omnisire.
If for some reason my webcam isn't... Start that. Yeah, I'm not. So just like pause while I be in here real quick. I have no idea why that's not working. And I'm not gonna screw that right now. A little disappointing though. Or how about very disappointing? Anyway, I have not yet played this before. I got it a couple months ago. I believe as part of my humble monthly subscription. Yeah, let's just... 4 months later. Seems capture size looks. What's wrong with? Okay. Yep. Why must it? Okay. Yeah, I don't know why my webcam captured. Call it good. Be one of my streams without some pointless technical difficulties. Alright, I think I got it. I'm gonna call that good enough. So let's get on with the game. Yes, they are. I don't know what the hell is wrong with this one. It worked fine the last time I did a stream. It was just decided this time to act up, I guess. So yeah, haven't really got into the game itself yet. I watched the intro cutscene, and now they're talking about the first mission. How does the audio sound? Can you hear it okay? Awesome. Right now, the only thing I know about this game is this some kind of turn-based combat thing set in Warhammer 40K. Agrolex sector located. Team reeks of stale, dusty antiquity. Once stern architecture littered with the tarnish with the patina of age. Here and there, fissures in the structure cast feeble light over cracked and tarnished. Doom was once brutalist and oppressive, if designed to crush the spirit of its inhabitants. No less intimidating now, but instead of evoking merciless, guiding intelligence, it speaks only mind and death. The place seems abandoned at first glance, but exploratory troops move through the corridors, the dust stirs, something long dead begins to be facsimile of life. So I'm gonna guess Necron. Or Necros, whatever they call them. Now, Steve has played Inquisitor, which is set in the 40K universe, but it's a different game. Which, speaking of which, I'm surprised Steve hasn't jumped in here, because I thought he wanted to watch this stream. I don't know. I'll make fun of him for ignoring it later. Enough talking. Let me kill something. Thank you. It probably is. Okay, so I'm not even going to explain the interface to me. I got to figure it out myself. That's fun. Okay, so it looks like my dudes are starting out over here. I can move them over there. Okay, I can drag the camera around. I will examine the obelisk. Okay, cool. I think that's my currency or resource for spending stuff. That's my regular option. Tracks my initiative advantage. These apparently are my troops. I guess I go battle these dudes. Aid or caution? Go on caution. That looks like the round turns. The Necrons are gonna go first. Then my guy. That's not great. There and there. Best place my I can concentrate fire on this one before I move on to the other one? Sure, we'll do that. Oh, okay, they can both hit me anyway. Never mind. Probably should have spread them out a little bit. Not sure, plus one cognition. Sure. Good. Nice. Excuse me. What's that dude's turn? Where can I can move pretty far in one turn. I don't want to do that. Oh, there? Okay, cool. I'm too close to that pillar. I can't hit him. Well, I guess I need to end my turn then. Okay. Hey, Steve. Yeah, I was telling her I was pretty sure it was Inquisitor you'd played. This one is more turn-based. Cool. In this game, I'm fighting the Necron. And I have a Servitor skull and everything. I have no idea what happened with my my webcam. Not working right. Of course I do. This is still the tutorial mission. Basically, I'm just moving room to room, clearing stuff out. It's kind of interesting because the game does not give you any real explanation for what the controls and stuff do as far as the interface goes. Because according to the game, that's not the the Adeptus Mechanicus way. They just mess around with stuff till they get it working. Basically, as you explore, you get options to either like attack and destroy things you don't understand, try to learn more about them, or ignore them. So I'm gonna try to study this. Oh crap! Well, I didn't actually get attacked, and I got some more resources. That wasn't. There's a ton of cognition points over there. This room actually looks kind of similar to the last one. I think it works better if I put everyone in the same corner and attack one guy till he's dead. We'll see how that turns out for me. That hurt. Thirsty. Oh, I didn't scout him with my servitor skull, so I have no idea how damaged he. That's interesting. Nice. Oh, that's not good. I'm assuming. And for me, this is kind of cool because I'm more familiar with the Xenos battling from the Space Hulk game. Seeing it from the tech priest side is kind of cool. I don't know, but that's why I called the stream to search for more toasters. I'm assuming they're going to show up eventually. So I guess I'll shoot these. What is going on? Oh, I'm getting shot. That's going on. Oh, I got an opportunity attack because it moved through my melee range. That's cool. Nice. Might be able to kill him in one shot. No. No, I could not. He has one hit point left. I'm gonna walk up and hit him with my axe. That should be the end of this battle. Nice. Purge the Zenos. Hit a bottle of water on here somewhere. Tombs are generally built to bury bodies in. I didn't realize that the Mechanicus on like modems talking to each other. Eat a healthy snack, like some carrot sticks or something. Great, looks like I broke one of my servitor skulls and one of my tech briefs. Good job. Lost contact with the Skitarii covering the entrance of the tomb. Not good. I'm gonna get ambushed. That's a good line. I should use that every time my alarm clock goes off. Is that a female tech priest? Do they even have male and female? You're gonna get me in trouble on this stream. Oh. So I can capture the Xenos and return it for study. I can annihilate the Xenos filth with righteous fury. Or I can retreat. If we were playing Deathwing, definitely purge the Xenos filth, but I'm thinking the Tech Priest would probably be better off capturing. Thoughts from you guys since you're watching? Yes, no, maybe. I'm thinking capture. Alright, that's what I'm going with. Oh, that's not good. You insist, but we might get our asses kicked. Wait. Survive 6 rounds. Final battle of the tutorial. Apply what you've learned so far and strive to be. I think the game just straight up told me I might die here. So I see 1, 2. Three Necrons. And that is dude, I guess I'm supposed to try to capture and or avoid. Where am I? I'm in the middle. I think if I run around a circle this way, I can take out two of the Necrons and avoid him. So I'm gonna try for that. I sailed the void. He looks like a living tank. This might have been a mistake. This was a mistake. Holy crap. He got almost... Where'd he go? Yeah, he's like almost right up on top of me already. Alright. I'll send my servitors out to get some cognition. That shit. I can't hit him from where I am. I'm also guessing I can't outrun him either. But I'm gonna give it a hell of a try. Suck it. I'm actually full on cognition. Maybe. Did I just end my turn right next to him? It'll be fine. Yeah, I already screwed up. I didn't shoot the turn when I had a chance. I really should have. Alright, boys, here's where we're making our last stand. Oh, God. Oh. I'm sorry, boys. Wow. Yeah, I got spanked like there was nothing. The readings from our squad's murder are troubling. They literally just said this. Hours. Seems like a long time. So it sounds like the game's gonna run under an overall time limit where I can only do so many missions before it's over. Right now the meter's at zero. I found the new sector. I can customize my priest, that's kind of cool. I'm glad they gave me new tech priests after I murdered my other squad. Wow, this is actually more in depth than I was expecting. Explorator, Secutor. Okay, see you in a bit. Ecoxilium. Flex mechanic. Well, apparently I was on mute the entire time. It's kind of embarrassing. So, I think I'm just going to use this dude to collect cognition this turn. I burned up a ton of it my last guy. Yeah, burning one cognition to get one cognition sounds stupid, so I guess I'll just move this and his. I think he's out of range for this shot. Yep, of course he is. We're gonna end his turn. And we're gonna move my servitor up. Or he's not gonna get there in time to do jack crap. How did that only do one damage to? I admit to being a tad frustrated. Go. This is the first real mission following the tutorial. That actually helps drive the awakening meter up after the mission is over. I thought it was related to what happened in the oh. So if I get like 4 or 5% awakening every mission, I'm only gonna be able to do about 20-ish missions before time runs out. I did not unlock any new cohorts, but I did unlock enough Blackstone where I can get some upgrades going. Oh, okay, that's like an armor adjustment. Plus one physical damage. Plus two hit points. Extra movement. Plus three hit points in armor. Plus two hit points in. I'm gonna go for the movement, because movement really seems like it's an important aspect. And that gave me an extra augment capacity. Heal. Out. I can unplug stuff and just sign it if I want to. But I think I need at least the ranged melee ability, so I'm going to keep that set. And the ability to heal. Okay. Done upgrading him. I gave him the Dominus. Because he gets a boost to ranged weapons. He's in desperate need of some freaking hit points. 3 hit point energy armor. 3 hit point max. Hit point. 1 energy. I'm going to go with the hit points and... Don't know if I want to give him the healing. Did it? No, you're right. I think it did. Hold on a second. Let me see if I can get that back up again. That should be back. I'll be wrapping this up in a minute, though. I'm going through my post-mission and upgrading my stuff. I think I'm going to go with the healing tool on my guys instead of the... Because this gives targets a 50% chance to miss, but it takes cognition to use. This just has a 3-turn cooldown. Kind of a no-brainer. Give yourself all the healing you can get. And I got a new weapon unlocked, it looks like. So this blaster is amazing, but it's gonna cost 3 cognition a shot to you. Holy crap. Why not? Oh, that takes up 2 augment slots to use. I do not have 2. There we go. Oh, that's cool. It actually, you can see the giant cannon on his shoulder now. Nice. Or what I could do, take that off of him and give him just 2 guns. Nope, that's a... So that way I have a gun to fire, even if I don't have cognition. Okay, I like that. He gets +4 range for ranged weapons. That ranged weapon dude. I do not think I have... I do not have enough to also. I did get a new canticle unlocked. Cant of the craft. Next physical attack will deal +3 damage. Although, I can't get Canticle of the Craft unlocked unless I complete missions without using Canticles, so... I guess I'm gonna see if I can get to the next couple without using any Canticles. This game, just on the surface, looks like it has more depth than, honestly, I was expecting. Yeah, so I got two missions. One is just a standard extermination mission. No, actually, no, I was collecting specimens. Then this guy's missions seem to be revolving around the religious side of the Mechanicus stuff. It does autosave, which is nice. But I'm still gonna do a manual save. I don't know how far back the auto saves will go. I don't know. I didn't get all super far into it today, but I'm pretty excited about it so far. So with that, I'm going to wrap up this stream. Hopefully the next time I do one, I can actually get my webcam thing working the right way, because... Not with it. It's not working. Don't get it. So everyone that tuned in, thanks for watching. I will catch you later. I might try to stream this again sometime this weekend. But it was fun. And I will be archiving this on my YouTube channel, as usual. So if you head over to the YouTube channel, please like, subscribe, notify, like, all that good stuff.